I do hope you're enjoying this Electrical Science and Principles series of videos that we're doing with Chris Horn from Riverside College, who also happens to be EFIX College Lecturer of the Year in 2023. And as I look at this board, I'm mildly disappointed because you said to me I was going to get a Tesla. Now, I thought I'd be driving around in a car. What have we got here, Chris?
We've got Nikola Tesla's theory of wireless electricity, something that he wanted to do, but obviously they didn't have the money at the time. And we've still not actually got over that. But what we have is we've got DC supply, we've got a little black transistor, 2222, and we've got 1.6k resistor, on and off switch, and we've got a coil of wire. On the other side here, guys, I've got an LED lamp with a coil of wire.
And you're telling me that you're going to be able to make that illuminate with no physical connection to the coil here. Now, it's DC, because you've told me they're batteries. Now, I know that once you turn on a DC supply, it will saturate that core. Unless we're very quick when we get that rising magnetic field, we won't actually get to illuminate. So how's that
going
to work?
So what's actually going to happen is, you're quite right, guys, we will just get one pulse of DC. However, with it going through the transistor will be fluctuating and switching that DC supply. Therefore, what will be happening is it'll be fluctuating magnetic field. What I'll do is I'll switch it on, and now the magnetic field will be fluctuating.
So on, off, on, off, on, off.
And yep. Hopefully you should be able to see
The LED illuminates. So electricity effectively passing through the air. So is this a similar principles that we see in transformers?
Yeah, similar principle. Mutual inductance, where it's the coil and my hand is actually picking up the fluctuating magnetic field given off by the stationary coil.
We've just turned off the lights just to give you a little bit better understanding of what's happening there. And we can clearly see now, can't we, that LED light is illuminated. And we've got a rising and collapsing magnetic field, which is DC, which is a little bit odd to us. If you were going to build one of these yourself at college in order to prove that electricity effectively moving through the air, the rising and collapsing of a magnetic field could induce a voltage into the other side. That voltage can be used, therefore, to illuminate that lamp.
Obviously, the further away it goes, the lower the voltage, and then the closer, get the higher voltage.
And if you're wondering what's in the background, because I always leave something in shot, you'll need to check out the video on screen now to find out what we get up to next.